Hello YouTubers, and welcome to this T4D. So as you can see, I did get my head shaved. I attended the event at St. Bernadette's. That was the event that St. Baldrick's were laying on. This was to raise money for Michael, the gent at my daughter's school who's got cancer. Thanks to those of you who contributed, really appreciate that. I'll just add a little short video clip of the event, and then down below there'll be a link to a Fox News video because they were there filming the event as well. Now the event itself, it was organized in a very short space of time, in fact only 2 weeks, so they only set their goal at about $20,000, but in that event they raised $60,000, so hats off to them, they did a really good job. Then a very big thank you for all the input on the 555 time tutorial that I did. At last my time is starting to free up to allow me the kind of breathing space to do bits and pieces like that. I had a lot of fun doing it. I learned a fair bit along the way. There were certainly things that I got wrong as well, or didn't quite correctly depict. So please, if you were interested in that tutorial, there are some very helpful, valuable comments which have been posted on there. Particularly if you go to part two and look down there, there's some valuable comments by a gent by the name of Matt, so go and read those. What has also arrived is the CMOS version of the 555 timer, and I've already created a video regarding the power consumption of the CMOS version. So I know there was some debate about the power consumption of the 555 timer. It'll just be interesting to see how the CMOS version of that compares. The CMOS version is called the TS555, whereas the normal 555 is called an NE555. I then also received the Regal DS2000 series oscilloscope. This is something I purchased recently because the specs are very similar to the Agilent that I've got. It's a direct competitor to the Agilent, and you get a lot of scope for the money, it has to be said. I'm going to be doing a quick tech video just to highlight some of the differences and similarities, and sometimes the contrast between them for the price point. Also, I've also got the DS6000 test board. And that's going to be a tool that I use in my evaluation between scopes. I can try and get a really good test platform to compare oscilloscopes. While I was at Regal, I received a catalog with all their products in it. In the catalog, it notes some of them as being new, but I noted that most of the ones that are new are already on the North American site. The one product, however, which is not on the North American site yet, and that is the M300 series data acquisition and switch system. Now this is a device which can help you collect and store data in many ways. It's got many mainframe inputs at the back. This is an area where Keith Lee and Agilent have had equipment like this, and I think Regal are trying to obviously bring something in at a relatively good price point. There's going to be a show at the end of March where I think they're going to be demonstrating it, and then they hope to have it on the market and probably on their website in about a month from now. But I will have a PDF linked below this video if you are interested in reading more of the specifications and what it's about. Right, so then before I end off, the one thing people of course have been nagging and asking about is the college power supply. And as I said, my time at last is starting to free up, so that I've got a bit more time to play myself. So I'm going to start purchasing the components that I don't yet have for it, and I'm going to start laying it out on a breadboard, doing a circuit diagram. Just please give me the time to do that and enjoy that myself, and as soon as I get to the point where I've got something that I can present to you, I will do, and we'll go through the circuit and understand how it works. And we'll then go through the process. We want to do a DIY PCB for it as well, and then an enclosure. Anyway, thank you very much. The video on the CMOS version of the 555 timer will be released tomorrow on Friday. But otherwise, thank you very much, and I'll catch you soon for the next video. Cheers.